Blackstone Audio presents Arab Winter Comes to America, The Truth About the War We're In, by Robert Spencer. This book is read by Russell Niemand. To those who are aware and resolute. Introduction. Why it's so hard to find out the truth about the war we're in. Plus, how I was banned in Britain and became an international pariah. When the Arab Spring revolutions began in Tunisia and Egypt in January 2011, the Western media reacted with unalloyed enthusiasm. Ignoring signs that the Muslim Brotherhood and other pro-Sharia Islamic supremacist groups were likely to be the big winners in the uprisings, the media assured Americans that the Arab Spring heralded a new flowering of democracy and pluralism in the Middle East. The fruits of the Arab Spring are now clear. By September 2013, less than 3 years after this movement began amid such hope, North Africa and the Middle East were in flames. The Muslim Brotherhood took over Egypt and then so alienated its citizens that it was driven from power after a year, ushering in a new era not of democracy and pluralism, but of uncertainty, violence, and strife. In Libya, where President Obama gave military aid to the anti-Gaddafi rebels, a U.S. consulate was attacked and a U.S. ambassador was murdered. And Islamic Jihad terrorists from all over the globe were flocking to the bloody civil war engulfing Syria, where military aid from the United States of America supported the side for which those jihadists were fighting. It quickly became apparent that the illusory Arab Spring had given way to a very real Arab winter. It wasn't strictly an Arab phenomenon at all, but a new and aggressive global resurgence of the Islamic Jihad that had already struck the United States on September 11, 2001. And on April 15, 2013, at the Boston Marathon, the Arab winter came to America. The jihad attack in Boston shows that our future in this country could be just as bloody as the present of the Muslim world. The violence at the Boston Marathon, and many similar recent plots across the United States, as this book will demonstrate, had exactly the same cause as the ongoing violence in Syria, Egypt, and Libya. Tragically, the United States is completely unprepared. The ideology behind the Boston Marathon bombing was the same ideology ascendant in the Arab Spring uprisings that were hailed by the media and the Obama administration as a new flowering of pro-Western sentiment and political and societal freedom in North Africa and the Middle East. It is no different from the ideology that motivated a Muslim U.S. Army psychiatrist to slaughter 13 Americans at Fort Hood in November 2009. It is identical to the belief system that inspired the 9/11 hijackers. Yet in the face of this renewed jihad has come from both the U.S. government and the mainstream media, denial, obfuscation, and worst of all, sympathy with those who have sworn to destroy the United States as a free nation and establish an Islamic state in its place. Heads in the sand. In this book, I detail the pervasiveness of that denial and illustrate just how destructive it is, as well as explaining the driving forces behind the jihadists operating now in the United States, their beliefs, their associations, and the international jihad network that has been working for the same goals around the globe. I also expose the details of the belief system of the jihad terrorists in the United States and explain the relationship between those beliefs and the agenda of moderate Muslim advocacy groups also operating here. This is essential information for Americans to have in the wake of the Boston bombings, the Fort Hood shooting, and other jihad terror activity on American soil. For, almost incredibly, even as Islamic terror activity is increasing, the Obama administration has systematically removed any mention of Islam and jihad from counter-terror training manuals for the FBI, the Department of Homeland Security, and other law enforcement and intelligence agencies. That whitewashing is playing a large part in the intelligence failures that make continuing jihad activity in the United States possible. Thus, it is crucial for every patriotic American and every lawmaker who wishes to counter the Obama administration's suicidally politically correct counter-terror policies to be fully informed about this dangerous belief system so as to be able to formulate strategies to counter it realistically and effectively.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.